Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And I know you enjoyed the last video, which was how to use ChatGPT as a social media manager. This video is the crash course tutorial that I said I might, and I might not shoot, but I'm shooting it because of you guys. So using ChatGPT is knowing how to prompt it. So you need to know how to instruct ChatGPT to get the best results. This video is going to be a tutorial video. I'm just going to show you like a brief walkthrough. I know there are many videos on YouTube that will tell you, okay, this is how you start, this is how you continue. You could go watch that for maybe step-by-step tutorial. But yeah, in this video, I'm going to be giving you prompts that will help you improve your efficiency and help you work faster, work smarter as a social media manager. So let's go right into the video. Before I continue, please don't forget to click the subscribe button if you're new here. It's very important to me that you click the subscribe button, turn on the notification bell, and like this video. Okay, let's go right into the video, shall we? It's using me looking this way. I'm looking at my script. I don't have a teleprompter yet, so my script is inside either my notepad or my iPad. So that's what I'll be looking at this side. All right, so let me start showing my screen. You can see here that this is my screen, and you can see openai.com. So that's the website you go to access ChatGPT. So you can scroll down. You can, if you're somebody that wants to like read and know more about it, you can scroll through it and explore, learn about the research, learn about OpenAI, explore their products, view their careers and all. But this is the part we want here. We want to try GPT. So I'm going to click on it and it's going to bring us to a new tab. So I already have GPT logged in, so that's why it brought me here directly. You want to also make sure that you're connected to the internet. Your internet speed is what is going to make you enjoy ChatGPT a lot. There's ChatGPT Plus, but I really don't need it at this particular moment because I get the very best from, how do I say, from using the normal free ChatGPT. You don't have to pay for everything, to be very honest. But the drawback is sometimes it tells me to regenerate, like it just gives me an error, and I hope it pops up so that I can show you guys the error that it gives me and how to fix it when you encounter that error. It's not, you don't have to close the app immediately. You can just refresh, and I'm definitely going to show you. So it has some things here that explains like the examples, the way you can instruct it, the capabilities. It remembers what user has said, meaning you can have a conversation with it. Allows users to provide follow-up corrections. You can train, it is also trained to decline inappropriate requests. Limitations, it may occasionally generate incorrect information. It has limited knowledge of world and events after 2021, and it may occasionally produce unfair instructions or biased content. So they've told you that already. So if you like search for something and everything, and it doesn't do, it falls into any of these three categories, just know that it's a limitation that they've already instructed you about previously. Now all your chats are here. You can see there are different chats. Like I have something called Latasha James social media. Like I used I analyzed YouTube page. I'm not gonna lie, I analyzed the YouTube page, and there are different ways you can do that, but I probably will teach you guys in another video. So that's why you can see something like that, and it says previous conversation. I have used GPT to the point where I know where my different these things are, like my different topics are in GPT. So you can check that out. You can create something like that. It's not like about checking it out or anything. So let's go right into the video. So the first thing you can use ChatGPT to do as a social media manager is you can use it to learn. And my iPad went off. So I want to show you what are the ways you can use ChatGPT to learn. What are the prompts you can instruct ChatGPT to do, and everything, like prompts that you can use it to learn how to create something. So I can say things like, okay, how can I create an effective social media content calendar? So I'm going to ask it to, how can I create an effective social media content calendar as a social media manager? Right? And I'm going to press enter. And yeah, thank God it brought up the error. So what do you do when it brings up the error? All you have to do is just copy. You want to copy your prompt again so you don't have to type it again. And then you refresh. That's all you do. You just refresh and type it in again and click on send. and then it's going to generate for you. So the error always comes up because a lot of people are using ChatGPT daily, and then maybe because you didn't instruct it right, or maybe you instructed it right, it's just like a bug. Do you get? It's just like a bug, and programmers know maybe when they want to decode or something like that. And ChatGPT is going to give you these things that you can use it to learn. You can use it to learn how can I create an effective social media manager. You can use it to also, let me give you another prompt on learning. You can ask it, can you suggest some tools of or resources that will help me, there's an issue in the will that will help me enhance my social media management skills. Yeah, so I want to, this error is still telling me the same thing, so I'm just going to like refresh. Like it keeps, lately the bugs have been like a lot, but so you just what you have to do is like just refresh, and you can start from the previous conversation. You know that I told you that it saves your previous response. This is the previous one, so you just start from there, and I'm going to like type Control V, and it makes my job easy to get. So it will tell you some tools that can help you enhance your social media management skills. ChatGPT is amazing. Like it goes to the internet sources for all this information and brings them to you in a simple format, in a conversation format and everything. Another thing you can use ChatGPT for is research. Now, when you're using ChatGPT for research, you can ask it questions like, so this is still generating, so I want it to finish generating. But the next one is research, right? Okay, so research, I'm going to ask it, what are some trending topics in my industry that I can incorporate into my social media strategy? Incorporate. I type really fast. I would say my industry is maybe sustainable fashion. You want to be very specific, right? And ChatGPT will generate that for you. So you want to ask it to, that's research. What are some topics to get? Another thing is, okay, so it's still generating, so it's telling me that okay, there's sustainable fashion practices, ethical fashion, circular fashion, like these are trending topics in the sustainable fashion niche that you can create content on. I can also tell it to, now there's something about continuing the conversation with ChatGPT. So you can tell me, can you give me content ideas based on this trending topics? Can you give me content ideas based on this trending topics? So I did not have to write this exact thing from beginning again. I just started a conversation. So, you know, you talked about sustainable fashion and practices, ethical fashion, circular fashion and all. It's going to give me content ideas one by one based on these topics. It's, you need to know how to prompt ChatGPT and have a conversation with it like you're having a conversation with your friend. Like you need to be able to like prompt ChatGPT, and it's prompting that actually works. So you can see there are like different ones. Another thing you can use it to do, again, research, is, all right, thank you so much. I just want to be cordial. Please go ahead to create group hashtags for Instagram for each of these trending topics. Like, it literally makes your life easier because now it's going to give me group hashtags for each of these trending topics. You can see the one for sustainable fashion practices. You can see the one for ethical fashion. You can see the one for circular fashion. You can see the one for sustainable lifestyle. Like, ChatGPT is amazing. You just need to know how to prompt it. Now, if you're a social media manager, for example, and you're like, okay, how can I like upskill? You can use ChatGPT to upskill, but then you need to understand these questions that you're asking it to upskill for you. And this is like the last part. Now, for example, I'm going to tell ChatGPT to create a social media proposal for a sustainable fashion brand. So I am very specific. So instead of telling you to create like a general social media proposal, I'm telling you to create a proposal for a sustainable fashion brand. And what ChatGPT will do for me is to create that. So you can see here, it gives me like an executive summary. It tells me where I'm to put the brand name. It gives me the objective of the brand. It gives me the target audience format. It gives me the social media platforms. Like, if you just tell it to create like a social media proposal, it's going to give you the general proposal. So, and you might not be easy to customize it and everything. So one thing I would like to do to tell you is you need to be very specific when you're prompting ChatGPT. Okay. The next thing I'm going to ask ChatGPT to do for me is to create a social media contract between me as a freelance social media manager and a sustainable fashion brand. Like, I'm letting ChatGPT know that I am a social media manager and my client is somebody that owns a sustainable fashion brand. So ChatGPT would now create a sample social media contract for me and the client, because I have been able to specifically instruct it that this is what my client does. Okay, so you can see here it tells me the social media calendar and the services, the terms, the fees and payment, expenses, intellectual property, confidentiality, like things that probably a lot of you forget to put in your contract. So it can help you come up with your contract and you get a lawyer to read through, sign it, co-sign it with you. Because if a lawyer doesn't co-sign it with you, the contract really doesn't actually stand like that in the court of law. So you want to make sure that a lawyer does that. So there's some things that does not refer, how I say it, pertain to you or to your like company and organization. So you need to understand what a contract entails and remove it from there. Okay, you don't just copy and paste from ChatGPT. You have to personalize also. So you can also tell ChatGPT to create a social listening report for a sustainable fashion brand. Like, I want ChatGPT to create a social listening report for sustainable fashion brand, because that's like my typical client. So at every point in time when I am prompting it, I'm telling you to create this one. Now, there's something about knowing how to interpret this thing and create the exact report, because all ChatGPT gives you is theory. And it's telling you that, okay, this is what should be contained in your social listening report. But if you don't even know what a social listening report is, they're just going to pick copy and paste from ChatGPT and some parts will be missing. So you need to also understand what this report entails. So you need to know what a social media strategy is. You need to know what a social listening report is. You need to know what content strategy is before you now instruct ChatGPT. Because trust me, this social media listening report, it's pretty big, pretty short. So I'm going to ask it. Another thing you can ask it for, another idea, please. Can you give me in another format? Because I want something different from this, right? And I'm going to like send it. Like, I want it in a different format. And ChatGPT is going to generate this social listening report in another format for me, right? All right, so the last thing I want you to do is create a pitch deck to my client. So I'm going to tell ChatGPT to, it's still generated, I'm just trying to like walk you through everything. Create a pitch deck to a social media management client for a sustainable fashion brand. You need to be very specific. You need to instruct it. So a lot of people will start their prompts like, oh, act as a social media manager. Or act me, I just go like, create. I need you to create this. Then it's up to you to now be able to like interpret what ChatGPT has given you as the social media manager. You need to understand what it entails to actually create like a pitch deck, a social media content strategy, a content calendar. You can tell ChatGPT to create a content calendar for you, but it won't create it in a content calendar format. It's going to create it in theory. So you need to understand what it entails to actually create something like that before you now proceed. What you get? So that's it, guys. Those are ways you can prompt ChatGPT as a social media manager. And I hope you found this video helpful, because I literally sat down and I'm like, okay, let's do a crash course for you guys. Please, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share with somebody. You can also join my community if you're like a new social media manager that needs to find their footing. You can join my community. You can check me out on Instagram. You can check me out on TikTok. And I see you guys in my next video. Okay, bye.